western northeastern part of Cecil County has shown strong rotation and is possibly producing a funnel cloud or a tornado. The radar site down in Sterling, Virginia is pretty far from it, but we do have a radar site down near Dover, Delaware, and that is the one that is picking up some pretty good spin on this system as it moves out of Baltimore, out of Cecil County, now over toward Newcastle County in Delaware. You get a closer view, stop the radar, look at the current picture, and there you have it. So again, the worst of the storm right on the Maryland-Delaware line now, and we could probably even see if there's any kind of wind speed rotation here that we can monitor. Normally where you see the reds and the greens coming together is where you kind of just focus your eyes, and we do see a couple of batches. I think this is the area right in this location. I'm also picking up maybe another second little twist over in that location, but the worst area I think would be out ahead of it right in there, just south of Newark and Delaware, right about on I-95, south of Newark, and to the northwest of Red Lion, Delaware, and east of the Elkton area. So again, take shelter now, far eastern sections of Cecil County in Maryland and Newcastle County in Delaware. These are the areas of prime concern at this hour. Donna?
I know, Tom, just wanted to let you know that we do have on the phone with us right now Richard Brooks, who is the head of emergency services in Cecil County. And Mr. Brooks, thanks for joining us. What's going on up there right now?
Well, like all of you, we've been monitoring the weather, you know, for the better part of the afternoon.
Sure.
And, you know, watching this particular cell that was just discussed, when it popped out, you know, we got the National Weather Service warning, and we put out all of our alerts to our volunteer fire companies and police agencies so that they're aware that the storm was tracking in our direction and did have the potential for the tornado.
Do they just go on high alert? Is there anything in particular that they do when you send out warnings like that to them?
Well, actually, you know, of course, the concern for us is, you know, the safety of the public, and as well the safety of our police officers and our firefighters and paramedics. So, yes, that's exactly what they do.
Yeah. And is it raining heavily where you are?
You know, I just heard him describe, you know, where we are, and that's our back door, and it is not physically on this side of Elkton raining at this time of
the month. Okay. Yeah, because I know they're expecting some, but as Tom was saying, this thing is moving super fast through that area.
It really is. It's incredibly fast, and we're watching, you know, some of the storm cells moving behind it, so we're going to be keeping an eye on those for the next couple hours as well.
Yeah, well, let us know if you see or hear anything up there, okay?
Yeah, right now the call volumes are quiet, so, you know, everybody take heed, and hopefully this thing will just pass through.
Yeah, let's hope. I hope it stays that way, right?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. All right, Richard Brooks, thank you so much for calling us from
sure.
Cecil County there.
Take care.
Thank you. And when a tornado warning is issued, of course, that's for the northeastern corner of Cecil County right now. Head for the lowest level of your building, interior rooms or doorways are the safest. Stay away from windows. And just cover your head and wait for the storm to move past. And if you get caught outside, crouch down in a low-lying area. So, Tom, as you heard, he said actually where he was, it was not raining at
okay,
the present
yeah.
time.
Yeah, that makes sense that these type of storms are isolated cells. You get out from underneath it and you got a nice sunny summer afternoon. But not far from you, there could be one of these big thunderstorms. And this one that we see here now, just to the south here. Actually, the storm is moving through Newark. The problem area for possible tornadic development is south of Newark on I-95. And then another storm system that we can see just to the west of that cell coming across the Susquehanna into Cecil County as well. So we're sort of training along that line. And you can see additional cells across the metro area. We're all under a severe thunderstorm watch until 9 o'clock this evening. But that one that's been popping out ahead of everything up there in Cecil County appears to be the biggest threat now for possible tornadic development. And again, right now it looks like the worst of it is just about all the way into Delaware. There's the new update from the radar now indicating less rotation and more of a hail-producing storm. So it is possible that the funnel will develop and dissipate if it is, or perhaps touch down and then lift off again. But right now the radar is indicating that this is primarily a large hail-producing storm, and it is moving off to the east at 22 miles an hour, headed over toward Cherry Hill at 441, and then right about now, then at Christine Manor about the same time. So about that time, it's moving very quickly, as we've been mentioning, and it's going to be scooting through the northern part of Newcastle County. I would say the threat is almost over for Cecil County, but we'll wait for the National Weather Service to give that the clear. Right now, I've been taking shelter in the Newark area, everybody along 95, in that general vicinity of this storm system as it makes its way to the east at about 20, 25 miles an hour, right along 95 or just north of I-95 is the location of most concern. Again, I think perhaps if there is a funnel, it would be sitting over in that location now. But again, the radar seems to indicate a little less activity as far as rotation goes. And sometimes the Weather Service will cancel these warnings as soon as they see that rotation stop. But for now, the warning for a possible tornado goes until 5 o'clock. This is from the National Weather Service up in Mount Holly, New Jersey. The Philadelphia